I don't know what's under the moon.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى سيدنا ومولانا محمد افضل صلواتك بأدل معلوماتك وبارك وسلم وصل عليه آية نمبر 52 كذاب آل فرعون similar to the behavior believers who were before Pharaoh and his people. So actually the bottom line is that Allah is giving them a warning that you don't know what happened to them, what happened to Pharaoh and to his people, what happened to the people of Nuh, Hud, Salih, Shu'aib and Lut. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you have the same like behavior, so my rule will never get changed. You will be having the same like result as well. Professor, you got it? This is the bottom line. Allah is not only referring to that your behavior is just like them. Your behavior is just like them, what mean? Your behavior is just like them. So you should look into their history, what happened to them. Got it? Kadabi Ali Firauna. Similar to the behavior of Pharaoh al-Lazina min qablihim and of those who were before them. What was their behavior? Kafaru bi ayatillahi, they disbelieved in the ayat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fa'akhadhahumullahu, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala seized them bi dhunubihim because of their sins and violations. Inna Allah qawiyyun, indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all-strong, shadeedul iqab, severe in punishment. Dhalika bi anna Allah, that is so because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lam yakun mughayyiran ni'matan. He will never change grace an'amaha ala qawmin, which he has bestowed on a people. Hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim, until they change what is in their own selves. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the all-hearer and the all-knower. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this ayah gave us a very clear concept that Allah gives His favors without cause and reason. You should write it. Allah gives His favors without cause and reasons. But when He withdraws, it has a cause and reason. That is the case. That's what the ayah says. When He withdraws, it has a cause and reason. And the cause and reason will be either punishment for that guy or a correction of that guy, or to raise him in degrees. Got it? If he is a nice man and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took away his health or his wealth, that is not punishment for him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is raising him now. Got it? But anyhow, for withdrawal, there is a cause and reason. Then, the same like ayah, we had in Surah Al-An'am, Bismillah,
chapter 6.
No, not Surah Al-An'am, Surah Al-An'am. Surah Ra'd, chapter 13. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Ayah number 11. لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِّن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ فَار ایچ پرسن لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ دیر آر اینجلز فالوئنگ ہیم فار ایچ پرسن دیر آر اینجلز فالوئنگ ہیم لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِّن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ لائک دی پیپل فالو یس لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِّن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ فَار ایچ پرسن دیر آر اینجلز فالوئنگ ہیم مِّن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ بِفور وَمِن خَلْفِهِ اینڈ بِہائنڈ ہیم يَحْفَظُونَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ اینڈ دے گارڈن بائی دی کمانڈ آف اللہ سبحانہ و تعالی سو دے آر کارڈ گارڈ اینجلز GUARD گارڈ اینجلز Otherwise, on each and every single step, you were supposed to stumble. Each and every single step, you were supposed to stumble. And these are angels who are protecting you. These angels are working like satellites. They are working like what? Like satellites from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, so the main switch is there with Allah. Yes, and these satellites are working. Got it? Or not?
Yes.
لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِّن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ فَار ایچ پرسن دیر آر مُعَقِّبَات In Afghanistan, we call them Sarandui. But Sarandui, sometimes they do fall for bad, sometimes they do fall for good. Yes? They do fall a position for bad and people in authority for good, for their protection. Got it? So these angels do follow us for good. لَهُ مُعَقِّبَاتٌ مِّن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ For each person مُعَقِّبَاتٌ There are angels following angels. مُعَقِّبَات mean?
Following.
Following angels. مِن بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ Before him وَمِن خَلْفِهِ And behind him يَحْفَظُونَهُ مِنْ أَمْرِ اللَّهِ They guard him by the command of Allah سبحانه وتعالى إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَيْرِهِ اللَّهَ لَا يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِقَوْمٍ He does not change مَا بِقَوْمٍ The condition of a people Are a condition of a people حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُ مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ As long as they do not change So now, the ayah has three meanings. One meaning is, that Allah, as we mentioned in the ayah of Surah Al-A'raf, that Allah gives favor for no reason. If you have health, it doesn't mean that you have done a great job for Allah, that's why Allah has given you health. Yes? If you have wealth, It doesn't mean that you are very close to Allah, that's why Allah has given you that much wealth. No, He is giving favor for no reason. But He withdraws the same for reason. And in reason, you must mention three things. Number one, either punishment. Number two, correction. Number three, raising His status. You wrote it? You have to memorize all these things like one, two, three. Yes? Yes or not?
Yes.
And not only that, wherever you are, be bold and brave and comparison. That we don't intercede. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not withdraw any favor, but it has a reason. And the reason is one of the three. What is that? Say Naseem. Well, because you are not taking your notebook with you. Sometimes I take it there from that counter and put it here. Yes. Which is the carelessness of a student. And for deen, we should not be careless. If we are not giving a due respect to the deen of Allah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never give us that favor. Yes, Qazi Abu Yusuf rahmatullahi alayhi, he was told by Imam Abu Hanifa, sorry to say that, but I have to say it. Even though if you don't like it, still I do the same. You know what I'm saying? Yes, you are not a bad guy. And even a bad son, he doesn't like his father to give him the seha. But still, the father is bound. If he will not do that, he would be punished. Yes, he would be punished. Today we are writing a hadith. Yes, that one guy would be taken by the angels towards the hellfire. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask them to stop him. They will stop him. What's wrong with this guy? He was doing good deeds, good actions, committed Muslim. Why you are taking him? Even though Allah has decreed to take him. Yes, but to show to the general public that what's wrong with this guy? So, what they will tell? Akala hasanatihi ayalu. His children have taken away all his good deeds. His children have taken away because he never thought of his children to give them proper training, a proper brother, a proper ta'aleem, a proper humanitarian ground. Yes? So, his good deeds are. So that's why I don't want to have my good deeds on the day of judgment being eaten out by your wife Fahim. Yes. Got it? So Qazi Abu Yusuf rahmatullahi alayh, Imam Abu Hanifa, Abu Yusuf said that Imam told me only one thing, that as long as you are not giving yourself in full to the deen of Allah, you are not giving yourself in full to the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this knowledge of deen will not give you a portion of it even. Got it? So that's called devotion. What is that called, Professor?
Devotion.
Yes. Got it? If not devotion, then there will be demotion. Yes. So Naseem, you are going to give devotion or demotion? Louder.
Devotion.
Yes. Don't be shy. Until what time? You are father now. Yes. Still he is shy. Yes. So that's number one. Our Shaykh Rahmatullahi Alayh, when he was giving us a sanad, so he told us. He told us, yes. Normally and on a regular basis, be soft with your student. But whenever you feel something, so Shaykh Rahmatullah Alayh said, don't do khiyana. Don't betray that student of evil. Yes, just tell him right at the moment that that's wrong. Got it? Because in Islam, knowledge is not that much important. Training is much more important. Yes, and that's why in Islamic political system, a very great scholar, his name is Allama Abul Hasan al-Mawardi. I have started a book on the Urdu one that's printed already in Pakistan. But now in English, I'm going to write it, Islamic political system. Yes. So Allama Abul Hasan al-Habib al-Mawardi, rahmatullahi alayh, he has written a very famous book that is called Al-Ahkam al-Sultaniyah. And it was not found long, long ago, disappeared from the whole world. People were looking for. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless the spirit and soul of Maulana Muhammad bin Muhammad.
Amen.
Your leader. Harakat al-Inqilab Islami. Yes, I asked him that Maulana Muhammad bin sir, I have an old nusha, an old volume of that book, and it's almost very close to get torn. He said, bring it to me. I took him to him. Yes, and he gave it to the printing press, and at that time, 10,000 volumes he printed and gave it to the ulama. So Allama Abul Hasan al-Habib al-Mawardi, rahmatullahi alayh, he has written a very famous book, that's an authority. In Islamic political system, that book is?
Authority.
Authority in political science. So Allama Mawardi, when he is talking about different ministries, so there he is talking about the education ministry. So the name he is giving, that is Wazarat al-Tarbiyat wa-Taleem. He doesn't say Wazarat al-Taleem or Wazarat al-Taleem wa-Tarbiyat. He says Wazarat al-Tarbiyat wa-Taleem. That Tarbiyat, proper training is prior to education. Proper training is? Because if you will not give a student a proper Tarbiyat, and you will give him education, and you will make him a doctor. Yes? So you are providing to the society a butcher. Yes? He will be exploiting people like what?
Butcher.
Like a butcher. Or a scientist, he will be doing the same. Or an attorney, he will be doing, yes, more than butcher. Why? Because he does not have proper training as a human and as a Muslim. You know what I'm saying? And that what Sadi Shirazi, he has said it very beautifully. You have to speak for you. A lot of letter.
No.
Okay, that's good. Yes, you can learn from Doja. Doja?
What?
You speak good?
Yes.
And what about you? So what he said, Sadi Shirazi, you, especially Naseem, you, Namudja, you, Waseem, for him, you, Dawja, you, and you, Dawja, also. Yes, because that's your language. So Sadi said, Ke be'adabra ilmufan amukhtan. Say it. Ilmufan.
Ilmufan
amukhtan. Amukhtan. Be'adabra ilmufan amukhtan. Dadani ter hasbadaste rasan. If you are given a specific subject, or skill in a specific subject to someone without tarbiyah, without training, that is just like giving a sword or a rifle or AK-47 to a robber. Mm. Yes? Giving AK-47 to whom?
To a robber.
To a robber. So what the robber will do with the AK-47? Yes, he will be robbing people using that weapon. So now that guy, he will be using that to fun, to rob people. What a beautiful share he said. Sadi. That's why he is called Sadi Jihangasht. What?
Sadi
Jihangasht. Jihangasht means he visited the world, and not only he visited, he was looking and pondering upon. Yes. One of his brothers is very famous regarding different nations. That how he studied the nations. Yes. He said in there, Ke Sadi Aroze Azal Rab Husna Batur Khan Dadan. You are from Turkey. Sadi Aroze, you have gone to Turkey. Handsome people. Yes or no? Sadi Aroze Azal Rab Husna Batur Khan Dadan. Zulfo Bachin.
Bachin.
Yes. These Thai people, Chinese people, Korean people, look at their hair. What a soft, shiny, you got it? Black. Zulfa barjeen, wa kamar narm bar iran dadan. Adabu fazlu balagat hama bamardu mehim. They are good writers. Adabu fazlu balagat hama bamardu mehim langu gairat hama bamardu mehya fahan dadan. Despite it is in their luck. Their luck are descended. They are dependent. Yes? So Sadi says, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was distributing qualities to people, so he knew the beauty to the people of Turkey. Yes, the soft, black, long hair to the people of China. Yes, and very thin waist to the people of Persia. Yes? Literature and writing to the people of India and fighting, unfortunately. Which is true.
Very true.
That's true, huh?
It's true.
Yes. Now, Eva, look at Sadi Shirazi at that time. Yes, what an observation he had. So he says, Ke beya dabra ilmu fan amukhtan dadani ter hasba daste razan. That just like giving a rifle or a bundukira to who?
To robber.
So that's why tarbiyah is prior to what?
Talim.
True.
Talim.
Talim. Lahu muakibatum min bene yadehi wa min khalfi lahu muakibatum. For each person there are angels min bene yadehi following him from before him wa min khalfi and from behind him yahfazuna min amrillah. They guard him by the command of Allah. In official and their own. Yet, as we say in Persian, as banda harkat, wo askudavan?
Barakat.
You should move, Allah will bless you. And if you are sitting here?
Harkat mein barakat.
If you are sitting here? Yes. You will never earn. Just go ahead. Do something, Allah will bless you. Yes? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I will never change the condition of a people as long as they are not trying to change their own condition. People who got the freedom, their freedom is not for free. They're suffering. Say,
no.
Lot of sacrifices. Is it or not? Professor? Yes. Sorry to say that, but that's history. How you people got freedom? They were for free? Yes. Thousands of people, they sacrificed their lives. Yes or not?
Yes.
Yeah. And thanks to Dr. Martin Luther King. Mm. Yes. And to people like him. To Malcolm X. Mm. And to who and who. Yes. God, we in India, we got freedom for free? Say?
No.
Yes, from Ambala to Amritsar. Even though the British government at that time, they did not have that much sufficient places to hang people, they were hanging ulama with each and every single tree. Yes. And one Britisher himself, he said, I was traveling from Ambala to Amritsar. At least I have seen 4,000 ulama hanging with the trees. So freedom was not for free. It was for free.
No.
Freedom has its own price. As long as the people are very much happy with the slavery. Yes, they will be slaves forever. Allah will never release them. He will not release their clutches because they are not doing. Professor, I am right or wrong? Bashir.
Assalamu alaikum.
Where Musa?
It's only in a class.
Inna illallah la yubayyiru ma biqaumin. Indeed, Allah does not change ma biqaumin. That condition which is on a specific people. Hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. But if they will try to change their condition themselves. That's number one. Number two, the same meaning which we have given already in Surah Al-Anfal. And the third meaning is, Inna Allah la yughayyiru ma bi qaumin. Indeed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never change the existing condition of a people. Hatta yughayyiru ma bi anfusihim. But if they will change their mental condition. Because change comes here from. Where from the change comes? Yes, that's called Taghir fil Fikr. That you have to change your way of thinking. Yes, if you are not free here, you cannot do anything. But if you are free there, then you will go ahead. So first, you have to bring change here. Where? Here. Then it will come out. Got it? And Muazzaf Ali Khan beautifully said. Muazzaf Ali Khan beautifully said. Ke khuda ne aaj tak us qaum ki halat nahi badli. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not changed the condition of a people up till now. Na ho jinko khayal aap apni halat ke badalne ka. Those who never thought of changing themselves. When they didn't think of changing themselves, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never brought a change to them. Got it? So now go back. Yes, that's how Quran is telling us. Professor, what do you think about this book of Allah? This is an answer for every problem or not?
Subhanallah.
Yes, that's good. This is a good answer. So go back to your salat. ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهِ That is because of that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala لَمْ يَكُمْ غَيِّرًا He will never change نَعْمَةً A grace on people and قَمَهَا عَلَىٰ قَوْمٍ which he has bestowed on a people حَتَّى يُغَيِّرُوا مَا بِأَنفُسِهِمْ until they change what is in their own selves وَأَنَّ اللَّهِ سَمِيعٌ عَلِيمٌ And verily Allah is all hearer and all knower. كَتَابِ آلِ فِرْعَوْنَ Similar to the behavior of the people of Pharaoh. وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ And those before them. كَذَّبُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ They belied destroyed the ayata, their land for Ahalakna. So we destroyed them with no beam for their sins. Wa Avrakna ala Firauna, and we drowned the people of Pharaoh. Wa kullum kanu zalimin, for they were the zalimin, the wrongdoer people. So if you are the zalimin, we will apply the same rule to you. Once again, the bottom line is, if you are the zalimin and the wrongdoer, so Allah says we will apply the same rule. Because I am not making amendments to my rule. Allah subhanahu, whatever rules He has established from day one, these rules will be going on until the day of judgment. Yes, that is not human made law, that they will bring change to this. Their situation change, let's go like this. Yes? Got it? In sharratawa bi'indallahi. الذين كفروا verily, the worst of moving and living entities, عند الله, in the eyes of Allah, or near Allah, are those كفروا disbelieved, فهم لا يؤمنون, so they do not believe. الذين, they are those عاهدت منهم, with whom you made a covenant, ثم ينقضون عهدهم, and then they are breaking their covenant, في كل مرة, every time, وهم لا يتقون, and they do not fear the break of promises. They are breaking their covenant. So it means, even the non-Muslims, they were bound to be committed and fulfill their obligations in this regard. Got it? Because there are humanitarian rules. There are humanitarian rules, and a human being is to be known through these rules, that he is human being or not. So if a Muslim is not a human, because he does not follow the human norms, what you can expect from him? And if a kafir is following those norms, you can expect a lot from that kafir and disbeliever. You can put your trust in that disbeliever, but you cannot put your trust in a so-called believer. Got it? فَإِمَّا تَرْقَفَنَّمْ فِي الْحَرْبِ. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those tribes who entered into a covenant and treaty with you, and then they broke it. And then they broke it. If you will find them in the battlefield, so give them a lesson. That, oh stupid guy, you also? Yes, Brutus? What? That in you? Say, Brutus? Yes. What Caesar said?
Yes.
You know the story? Where are you? Yes. Who knows the story? Huh? Who knows the story?
That was his.
Huh? Huh? YouTube Brutus? So Brutus was a close associate of Caesar. Yes? When the people revolted to Caesar, and they were hitting him from all around. So Brutus is close associate, because some people, they are flowing with the flow of the water. Yes, they are flowing with the blow of the wind. Yes, so Brutus, he was a dependable and reliable friend of Caesar. But he stayed him from his bed. Yes, and that hit, even though so many people were hitting him, but that caused him a lot of pain. So he was there, his bed. So that was his close associate. Yes, and it broke his heart. He fell down because his heart was broken, because of that heartbreaking action of his own friend. He said in his last moment only one single sentence, you do Brutus? Yes, and he fell down. Remember that. This is history. Yes?
Yes.
You are unhappy with us today, don't you know? Huh? Why? Everything is okay? فَإِمَّا
تَسْتَفَنَّمْ
فِي الْحَرْبِ. So if you gain the mastery over them in war, or you find them in war, فَشَرِّدْ بِهِمْ مَنْ خَلْفَهُمْ فَشَرِّدْ بِهِمْ مَنْ خَلْفَهُمْ. It has two meanings. فَشَرِّدْ بِهِمْ مَنْ خَلْفَهُمْ. So punish them in such a way that people behind them may get dispersed. Oh my God. Yes, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, give them such a punishment that those who are behind them, they may get dispersed. That's number one. And number two. فَإِمَّا تَسْقَفَنَّهُمْ فِي الْحَرْبِ فَشَرِّبْ بِهِمْ مَنْ خَلْفَهُمْ So disperse them, people from behind them, hit them from the back. Those who are supporting them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, hit them from the back. So they may not get support. They may not get support. فَشَرِّبْ بِهِمْ مَنْ خَلْفَهُمْ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَذَّكَّرُونَ So that they may learn a lesson. وَإِمَّا تَخَافَنَّ مِنْ قَوْمِ خِيَانَةً Yes, and there were people who were in treaty with Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam experienced breakage of covenant from so many tribes. So he had concern about other tribes also. That if at the time they will break the promise, so then what? Yes, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, living in reservation will never work. Living in reservations will never work. If you have reservation, tell them, no covenant, that's gone. Yes. What a beautiful rule this Surah Al-Anfal is telling. Yes. وَإِمَّا تَخَافَنَّ مِنْ قَوْمٍ خِيَانَةً And if you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you fear treachery from any people, from مِزِلِهِمْ فَلَا سَوَى So throw back your covenant to them on equal terms. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْخَائِنِينَ And you may not cheat them as they are cheating you. No, tell them that, okay, from now onward, you treat me. Don't attack them before telling them. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, I don't like cheating. Yes, and you are a role model. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْخَائِنِينَ Certainly, Allah does not like the treacherous people. وَلَا يَخْصَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا سَبَبُ And let not those who disbelieve think that they can outstrip or escape from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِنَّهُمْ لَا يُعْجِزُونَ They cannot weaken us at all. They cannot weaken us. وَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَسْتَطَاتٌ مِنْ قُوَةٍ And make ready for them مَسْتَطَاتٌ Whatever you can do مِنْ قُوَةٍ The power. Whatever power you can do. As I mentioned, that according to Jumhur, the relation between a Muslim and non-Muslim state, the base should be peace. The base should be what? Peace. And war will be temporary. War will be temporary. That's what Jumhur say. Imam Malik, Imam Shafi and Ahmad. Imam Abu Hanifa Rahmatullah alayhi says, the war preparation or the battle preparation is the base. The peace is temporary. What a good thinker he was. He said because if you are careless about them, that they will never do any wrong to me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, who knows? They are cheating Allah, they will cheat you as well. They are cheating Allah. So what you can expect from them? So never say that my peace with them is everlasting. No, this is temporary. So it doesn't mean just go and fight. No, be ready for fight anytime. Your preparation should be there. Got it? Deterrence. What is that? What is that problem? Preemptive. Yeah, not preemptive. Preemptive is war. But deterrence. You have to be ready. If something happened, so at that time, oh, I wish I have done it. Oh, we wish we have done it. But right now we are too late. Yes, now you will lose your country. Then after that, make depression. Yes. You will lose your country. Then after that, you have to
make effort.
Make for what?
For what?
Slavery. You will be making preparation for what? For slavery. Got it? Yes. So what do you think? Yes, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless Imam Malik and Imam Shafi and Ahmad Muhammad as well.
Ameen.
But whose approach is very technical?
Abu Hanifa from the Lord.
Abu Hanifa was a universal guy. وَاعِدُّوا لَهُمْ And make ready or make preparation long for them, mastatatu. Whatever you can do, milkuvati of power. Of what?
Of power.
Power. So power includes every single thing. Economical power, political power, yes. Technological power, yes. You know what I'm saying? Weaponry power, yes. Army power, yes. It means every single thing. وَعِدُّ لَهُمْ مَسْتَطَاتُمْ مِنْ قُوَ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ including the professor, the horses for fight, they have a special word.
Steed.
Yes. S-T-E-E-D.
Yes.
Yes. وَعِدُّ لَهُمْ مَسْتَطَاتُمْ مِنْ قُوَ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ including steeds of war. So at that time, these were horses. Nowadays, these are Al-Khalid and Abdullah. Where is Al-Khalid and Abdullah?
Pakistan.
In Pakistan. Yes. Tanks. Wa'iddu. There are like Mercedes. Yes. They say that this is the swift ever tanks all over the world. Wa'iddu lahum mastata'tum min quwwa. وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ And yesterday they hit a new thing, Hataf, sailing. Hataf, sailing, which takes the atomic warhead. For how long? The range was very, very, very big. وَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَسْتَ We are dying of hunger here, but they are making these things. People are dying of hunger, but this is okay, another Hataf. وَعِدُّ لَهُمْ مَسْتَطَاتُمْ مِنْ قُوَ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ I think that their nature is also like Pashtun nature. Pashtun is dying of hunger, but they say, take a partner, say, oh, it's a must. Take a partner,
say?
Yes. From our area, when people went to Dubai and Kuwait and Qatar and all these states where they are doing level. So the first ever check they sent there, they sent there by an ekafrasil. وَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ This is nature. وَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَسْتَطَاتُمْ مِنْ قُوَ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ Even though, alhamdulillah, we don't need that. But let's say we need that. We don't need that. Situation is not there, but we need it in culture. We need it what? وَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَسْتَطَاتُمْ مِنْ قُوَ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ تُرْحِقُونَ بِهِ عَدُوَ اللَّهِ وَعَدُوَكُمْ And as you know, that the culture is dominant. So in dominant culture, your nature is getting changed. Yes? I will never hit a bird anymore. I will never hit a bird for no reason. Yes? Because that is wrong. That is wrong. And that's why Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he cursed a guy who is hitting the birds or the animal for no reason. Just only to enjoy it, to entertain. Does that make sense? If that is eatable, yes, just go ahead and then you will eat it. But if that is not eatable and it does not harm, so why you are hitting it? Prophet ﷺ cursed. That's why you are doing that to the Krishna Kala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know? So I will never hit a bird, but still, Mamuja and Muslim.
Different bird. Different bird.
وَعِدُّ لَهُمْ مَسْتَطَاتُمْ مِنْ قُوَ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ Even though we are, every year we are paying a lot to the government for the licenses. For no reason. But we have وَعِدُّ لَهُمْ مَسْتَطَاتُمْ مِنْ قُوَ وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ تُرْهِبُونَ بِي عَدُوَ اللَّهِ وَعَدُوَكُمْ Because in Pakistan you cannot have any gun without license. Yes? You have to pay to the government every year. Yes? Got it? وَعِدُّوا لَهُمْ مَسْتَطَاتُمْ مِنْ قُوَى and prepare for them. Or be ready against them. مَسْتَطَاتُمْ مِنْ قُوَى whatever you can do. مِنْ قُوَى أَبْطَوَى وَمِنْ رِبَاطِ الْخَيْلِ including steeds of war, the tanks. Yes, the planes, the missiles, things like that, because now the situation is changed. Turhibunabi aduwallahi wa aduwakum, to threaten the enemies of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and your enemies. Now look, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not say, taqtulunabi aduwallahi wa aduwakum, to kill the enemies of Allah and your enemies. No. Turhibunabi aduwallahi, and that's why we say that actually weapon is deterrent. That's what?
Deterrent.
It is deterrent. And that's what Newton said when he was asked that you made this shaitan thing, what?
Atomic.
The atomic bomb. He said that, what after this? What up? And what will happen to the world? So he said, Zuwajhem kada. Maybe you can explain it either way. So he said that because of this, people will be fighting with stick and stones. People will be fighting with sticks and stones, which means that people will not be using that. Because if one will use it, the other will use it as well. Or maybe the one will go to his extreme, so the other will. Yet let's have it. You know what I'm saying? So he said that people will be using regular types of arms and they will not go towards their harmful arms. Otherwise, maybe the emotional guy, he will. That let's have an end of the story, fire. You know what I'm saying? And the second meaning is that if people will have it and they use it and they use it and they use it. So what will remain there? Nothing will remain. A few people who will be living here and fighting going on, so nothing will be thrown stone and sticks. Got it? Because atom is an azab. Atom bomb is what? Professor, what do you think? Atom bomb is what? It is an azab.
The enemies of Allah and your enemies, and others beside them. That you do not know. Allah knows that. And whatever you are spending fi sabilillah in the cause of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, yuwaffikum, it would be given to you in full its reward. Wa antum la tuzlamuna, and you shall not be treated unjustly. Wa in janahu lis-salmi.
Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we mentioned time and again, to start a war in Islam is very difficult. It has a lot of conditions. Because Islam is basically a religion of peace. That's not a religion of
war.
To start a war, that is very difficult. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, when it is started, then just go ahead. Then do not turn around. Then go ahead. Yes, when the war is going on, sometime your enemy will say that we are asking for a peace treaty. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, you started with condition. You are going ahead. Now they are asking for peace treaty. So what you will do? So Allah says,
and if they incline to peace, also incline to that. What the wakkal malallah?
Yes, reservations will be there. Maybe they were cheated. Maybe they are making preparation. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if these reservations are there, so there will be no any peace to be able to do. Yes? So that's why Allah said,
what the wakkal malallah, and put your trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Innahu huwa sami'u, indeed he is the all-hearer, al-alimu, and the all-knower. Wa in yuridu an yahdabuka, and if they intend to deceive you, fa inna hasbaka Allahu, so then verily Allah is all-sufficient for you. Huwa allazi ayyadaka, he is the one who helped you, bi nasri, with his support, wa bil mu'minina, and with the support of the believer. Wa allafa bayna qulubihim, and he is united their hearts to each other. Lawan faqtama filat,
otherwise the tribe of Khazraj and the tribe of Aus, they were killing each other for hundreds of years. Now they are sitting together, all united. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, if you would have spent the gold and silver of the entire world, you could not have united them in the same way. That's what Allah did.
Wa allafa bayna qulubihim, and he has united their hearts. Lawan faqtama fil arzi jami'an, if you would have spent all that in the earth, ma allafta bayna قلوبهم you could not have united their hearts ولكن الله ألف بينهم but that is Allah who has united them إنه عزيز حكيم certainly is almighty and all wise
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله محمد وعلى أصحابه أجمعين اللهم رب الحمد لله رب العالمين وزكنا وغفرنا نسينا وعلمنا من ما جهلنا وقدرنا طغنا عليه ظننا النهار الله خير حافظ ورحمه رحيم